Please welcome Esther Ngumbi.
My mother was born in Machakos, Kenya, a region that valued learning, a culture that emphasized to girls that they needed to put education first before everything else, including beauty. She pursued her education to the very end. She ultimately graduated with a diploma and became an elementary school teacher. So, when she raised and gave birth to us, her five children, she made sure we understood from the word go that schooling would always come first. But you see, she was raising us in a different region. She was raising us in the Kenyan coast, a region she had moved there soon after obtaining her diploma, simply because during her time, it was the government of Kenya that would decide where newly fresh trained teachers would start their career. And in the Kenyan coast region, people appreciated beauty from the tender age, and they emphasized less on education. In my community, girls were very beautiful, and I mean very beautiful. Their ears were pierced, and so were their nose. They put on mascara, and they painted their legs and feet with henna. And I admired them day after day. And the more I admired them, the more I felt the need to blend in. I wanted to pierce my ears so badly. So from the age of 6 to the age of 10, I kept on questioning my mother. I said to her, "Mama, can I have my ears pierced?" And year after year, her answer would never change. "Education first, beauty later," she would say. But you see, teenage years were fast approaching. And the need to look beautiful so as to attract the attention of boys was beginning to grow in me. And all my friends had their ears pierced, and of course they had their boyfriends. I did not have none. And I blamed it all on my unaccessorized face, thanks to my mother. On the weekends, my friends would come to play, and half of our playtime was filled with stories about their first teenage boyfriends, how they were feeling so appreciated by these first loves. And of course, I had none. Then one Saturday morning, my friend Wanasha and other friends came to play with us. And this Saturday morning, she was looking beautiful. You see, she was wearing her brand new earrings. They were round with a gold tone and with many sparkling beads. Oh, she looked beautiful. And those earrings were just popping against her beautiful light skin color. And I remember Monasha did not want to play with me as usual. She wanted to tell me something. So she pulled me aside and she started whispering into my ears, "Oh, I got my first boyfriend. The kiss, oh, this boy is making me feel so loved." And on she talked. And I remember halfway feeling very angry, angry at my mother. Why wasn't my mother allowing me to look like my friends? And I remember saying, "Enough, enough." I was going to pierce my ears. But you see, I was growing in a village where there's no Walmart or Claire's to go get my ears pierced. So I had to do it the old school way, which is self-piercing with a needle and a thread. So I start assembling the tools that I would need to accomplish this dangerous beauty mission. I go to my parents' bedroom where the sewing kit is kept. I grab a middle-sized needle and I grab a thread, a black thread. I also grab a wall mirror that I would put on the wall to make sure that I pierce my ears at the right position. And I decide that the bathroom is the most safest place for me to pierce my ears. So I take my kit and off I go. I lock the door and I take the needle and I put the thread and I put the wall mirror so that I could see what I was doing. I start pushing the needle and I'm feeling pain, but my pain is overshadowed by the beautiful Esther I'm imagining I will look like. Oh, my first kiss, my first boyfriend. After a minute, the needle pierces through my earlobe. I tie the thread and I repeat the process. I start pushing again, and after what seems like eternity, my second ear is done. I take a big sigh and take a minute to appreciate my beautiful me. So I assemble my kit, and while assembling my kit, I also decide that I need to hide my piercings away from my mother. So I decide I'm going to wear a head wrap. But my small brain does not realize this is actually going to make me stand out in front of my mother. But I do it anyway. It's 6 p.m., and my mother returns from her church event. I go run, I grab her bag, I hug her, and I see her take a glance at my head wrap, but she says nothing. So I assume we are cool, everything is okay. An hour later, dinner is ready, and I must serve it. I serve it, and I take my seat on the table. We all eat peacefully until the last minute, when I'm just about to put the last bite on my mouth, my mother calls my name. I begin to tremble and I drop the food that I was about to put into my mouth. Is there any reason why you have a head scarf? And before I can blink, she is right behind me. She pulls the head wrap. And before I can even blink, she slaps me twice. And she proceeds to ask one of my sisters to go get a pair of scissors. And I'm just explaining myself, Mama, I just wanted to look beautiful. And before I know it, she slaps me again. And before I can blink, she takes the scissors and cuts the thread and just yanks them out of my ears. Mama, if you really want and love me, why? Why don't you want me to look beautiful? At this point, she stops punishing me. She wants to talk. She takes a big sigh. She tells me about her girlfriends who had put beauty first and what ended up becoming of them. Today, they were mothers with many children and living in abject poverty. She did not want me and my sisters to turn out like her girlfriends. She wanted the best for us. As she's talking, a switch is flipping. I'm telling myself I must prove to my mother that I'm not like her girlfriends, that I am empowered and committed enough and self-confident enough to pursue my education and not allow beauty to distract me. Today, I proceed on. I go to elementary school. I finish it. I finish my high school. And also go to university. Today, I have a PhD in entomology. And I also have 4 sets of ear piercings. And my nose is pierced too. And I share a beautiful relationship with my mother. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's Esther Ngumbi.